Just waiting for our flight. Just had a lovely, got mugged off at
Costa.
Yeah, like £3 for a ham and cheese toasty. Wasn't even that nice, I'm going to be honest. Bit mediocre. And then we've got the lovely ladies here.
We are missing one person, that would be James.
And the teacher, Tom. Okay, so we're on the flight over to Madagascar. It's a 10-hour flight. Been here for about 3 hours, and why were we delayed?
About an hour, half an hour.
And why was that?
Just because of luggage.
Luggage problems. So we were sitting on the, just in the terminal on the plane for about an hour, at least half an hour. We weren't told why, we were just sitting there. And Megan, when she sat down next to me, found a fold-out knife. So that's always, it's good that they've managed to get the security right here. But the food, we've just had our lunch, and it was really nice. Free bottle of glass of wine with it. So even James got it, so that's a bit naughty really. He's only a baby.
So good.
So we've had lots of food, now probably going to get a few hours sleep before we touch down in Madagascar in about 6 hours time.
Okay, so we've arrived in Madagascar, it's boiling hot, it is so crowded, and we don't seem to be moving at all. But I've all seen our bags, they're free.
So they've at least landed, but we need to find them. And we've just got to get our visas. Yeah. It's rather hot though, so fun times. See you all at our hotel later.
See you later.
James, so what happened at the airport in Madagascar today?
What happened at the airport? Well, basically, they lost my luggage. Not my hand luggage, my actual big.
Your big luggage?
Yeah.
The important luggage.
We were there for about an hour, at least an hour extra, getting in forms and stuff, and hopefully it'll be back on Monday, delivered to us.
Yeah. And this is after we'd waited, 2 hours in the queue trying to get the visa?
Visas, yeah.
So,
just to get a stamp.
See, that was a good introduction for Madagascar.
Yeah. On a 12-hour bus journey now. Stayed in a hotel in Antananarivo last night. Got anything to say yet, Thomas?
That I want to sleep. I am very tired, exhausted from a long plane journey and a very, very short sleep last night.
We were up at about 6 o'clock. Half six. We technically didn't wake up in time, but no one's keeping track. It's all right. Had a quick breakfast, but everyone seems to be up here, up and out running so early and things. Saw the army just casually march past.
Navigating through the people on the roads.
Suburbs.
So many paddy fields.
Which is bad because we've got the BSAT qualification.
Oh, that's great.
Hakuna Matata. What a wonderful phrase. Hakuna Matata. Ain't no passing craze. It means no worries for the rest of your days. It's our problem free.
We've just got back to our new hotel. We've been travelling for about 13 hours in total, but that does include stops for food and a toilet stop, and also looking for some alligators in a swamp.
Crocodiles.
We've just had ordered. We've got a 3-course meal and some drinks as soon as we got here. Anything to add, guys?
Tired.
Very tired.
Legs hurt a bit from sitting at the back. I'm going to nap. Alright, just getting ready, unpacking everything and getting it
prepare for dirt, repacked and organised.
First Sunday of the trip, not too bad, just turned up to the camp. It's pretty nice actually, better than what we expected. Nice little shower, weren't too bad.
Yeah, a 4 hour trip here on like 4x4. We were split up into two groups, the lads and the girls, and really, really dusty and really bumpy. The driver's door swung open about three times when he was driving, so he just had to carry on driving, one-handed over round corners and things, shutting the door and holding the door shut. And then we hit a massive rock and the back door swung open. Luckily none of the bags fell out, but it was close. But finally here, I'll just turn the camera around and show you what our camp for the next 3 days, is it?
Yeah, 3 days, and then we're off to the next one.
So this is just where we've got a row of tents here, and then I'm over there somewhere.
Just behind
on
us.
That one. And then so we've got there, then we've got food over here.
The shop to the left.
Shop just down there.
And beer nurse.
And then over here is where we've got like washing quarters or anything. Yeah. And we have had some lemurs behind us, but
there's one up there in the papaya tree. Probably can't see it very well. And
one there. Just chilling. Where am I looking?
Just in there, into the tree next to it. And
no, I cannot see.
Just me then.
No, I'm trying to. I can physically see him.
Right.
Just not with the camera.
Probably because it's a bit dark in there.
I was just trying to zoom in. Oh, there we go. Found him. Look at him there, just chilling.
Scratching.
You could be so many people if you make that grab for freedom. What have you done today to make you feel proud? Yeah, we need a change. Yeah, do it today. Yeah. My spirit rising, change, yeah. We need a change, yeah. So do it today, yeah. 'Cause I can see a clear horizon.
Alright, so we woke up about 6:30 this morning because we were going on a boat expedition,
mm-hmm.
which was pretty good. It was about an hour walk down there, would you say?
Probably a bit longer.
Probably a bit longer than that, and then we got on a boat and we travelled down the river. We saw a lot of birds. Didn't see a crocodile, unfortunately.
Because tide was up.
Because the tide was up, yeah. And then we didn't see much on the way back, but we saw some critically endangered birds.
Fish eagles.
And then we saw some lemurs.
Hognose snake on the way down.
Which nutmegged me, just carried on going around my legs. It was a little bit...
pretty cool.
A little bit weird.
Just
about to have lunch and a few...
We also just earlier saw another snake. Is it a leaf note? Leaf? Well,
yeah.
Like a leaf head or something like that. It looked like a branch.
So that was quite
pretty
cool.
Pretty much.
It's quite all got to hold it and
quite
things.
Quite rare.
We had these sort of balls of donut for breakfast with sugar. They're all right, quite been deep fried in oil, so quite early, but no, it was nice. Just about to have lunch, and then we're going out to look at the flowers of the forest. So we're on a night walk searching for some, well, any sort of reptiles really. Seen a frog and a few chameleon and lizards.
Yeah.
And a kingfisher, but that's not really a chameleon.
The trees.
Some monkeys.
Mouse
lemurs. But haven't had much luck. We've still got a couple of hours to go.
Just looking for some geckos, really.
It's really humid today, but a nice day though. So report back to you when we find something, or if. Yeah, so James, what was that and where are we?
We're in the jungle outside second camp, and that was Safaka Lima.
Okay.
This is a group of four, and they're making that sound, you might be able to hear, because they've been hunted before, and that's them being angry at us.
It wasn't us, though.
It wasn't us hunting them.
It's like another tribe, they say, that people, they don't have any near them, so they're trying to get some. So, it's about, what? 10 to 9, we've been out for nearly 2 hours now, looking at on a lima route, and then we're going to do some forest plot where you measure the diameters of trees and things. So it was an early morning start, but it's going to be well worth it. Okay, so pretty much we're doing the rainforest plot canopy cover now, and then Tom and I are sitting out a 20 by 20 grid. And the circumference of the first tree was 1.10 meters. So I've got on here, can't really see. So I'm up to 21.10. So I need to turn 90 degrees now. And now if you look at 90 degrees, so I'm gonna have to try and, yeah, nice and thick, gonna have to try and get the rest of the plot done. Camp at Matsudroi. This is what we woke up to every morning. It's just going to be a quick tour because we're a little tight on time. So come here. These are our lovely zebu carts taking us all our luggage today, apart from our handheld. This is where we had our lovely rice meals, and then
through there.
All right, lovely job. We've got the medic's tent up there, which.
Clean.
Had fun with. We played bowls here, which I don't like to boast, but I beat Tom on numerous occasions.
My bowls broke, so that.
Wave to the camera, guys. Yeah, there's some lovely hammocks there. And we're going up to our tents quickly. Yeah, I like a massive hole in my trousers from being too hench.
We lifted like a 10 stone log.
So this is where our tents were for the, what, 3 nights we were here?
I broke mine.
James broke his,
this,
so.
This is my crib. It's pretty gnarly inside. A lot of space.
Yeah, we're going to ignore him now. They can sleep up to 4 people, and we had one each, so we had loads of space, which was nice, because we're such a small group. Okay, now we're getting to the grim area. Yeah, this is the toilets. You've got, if you need to go for a number two, you've got the boys' number two there.
And I think the boys have got the lackey.
If you need to go for girls' number two, which personally I didn't, there. And then we've got the number ones around there. Got a lovely washing line and showers down here. So we're off to do about a 1.5-2 hours walk.
Can't
back
wait.
Back to our the first camp, which was
Mariano.
And then a 5-hour journey to somewhere else.
National park or something.
All right, that's our call, we've got to go.
Okay, guys, so we're on car journey, truck journey back from Mariano. It's a bit bumpy, but it's fine. We've just passed another van, so obviously it's really dusty, so your windows up. Yeah. We found that out on the way here. We got absolutely caked. Guys, got anything to say?
Pretty much, it's a bit bumpy as you can tell. We're going everywhere, but it's quite worth it.
One minute, I'll show them this. Right. Oh, one minute. That's not what you want to see. So you can see it's a little bit dusty. We've got Scooby doing the front, so it's all good. And that's our guide in the front, who's been talking to us about the politics of the country, which we didn't know. It's very interesting. Do you just want to say hi to the camera?
Hi there.
He speaks brilliant English, obviously, and sounds very American, which I love. I think we're staying. Where are we staying tonight?
Oh, staying at the national park.
Yes.
Yeah. The national park, and then we've got about a 10-hour journey, and then off to Nosy Bee for diving. So halfway through the trip, and it's going really well. Alright, James.
He's got a complicated.
Tell us what's happening.
I will explain to someday.
We're on a boat. No, I don't swear. It's going to be a good one. Yeah, we got here at about 9, but it's now quarter to 11. We had to wait for the tide.
We're badasses because we're not wearing a life jacket. Yeah, one of the other
ones.
It's alright, I can swim.
I might take my hat off, actually. And the girls are over on the other side of the queue. I've tried to cut these corners, try to take the easy way.
At Nosy Bee now, had a tour of the village and found out what our boundaries are. We can go quite far, to be fair. Boundary does stop at the tavern though, so that's a bit of a shame. But there's a couple bridges, the sea is amazing, the views are pretty nice, and you get to see a full moon. It's pretty cool. Can't get to see the sunset though, because there's a ridge in the way, which is a shame. Other than that, it's really nice here. Anything to say, Dan?
No, not really, just looking forward to our first dive tomorrow.
You're good.
2, 1, roll. I'm on top of the world.
just like a waving flag.
So we've been at Nosy Bay, the diving part of our trip, for 5 days. This is our fifth and last day, so we're frantically packing, or trying to. In total, we've had 6 dives, which is pretty cool, and a lot of snorkeling and just generally chillaxing and having a good time. Meg, got anything to say?
We saw a turtle!
And Tom, will you explain what we were doing today? Because obviously we can't dive, because you can't have nitrogen in your blood, because we're flying early tomorrow, so they didn't want to risk it. So we did something a little bit different today. Thomas, explain it, will you?
Pretty much went to this island. Can't remember what it was called, was it? I haven't got a clue. But instead of diving, we snorkeled, and it was amazing. It was just sand, white sand. The water was clear, I saw a massive batfish, a couple of guys saw a turtle. Me and James saw some cuttlefish, which was pretty cool, a group of them. And there was just shoals of fish, 300 plus,
yeah.
Little ones, big ones, it was amazing. It was pretty cool.
How long were we there for?
We were there from about 9-ish to about 3.
So we had a nice full day.
Full day snorkeling. And just ending the last day on a high, pretty much.
Okay, so it's 6:25. We're off for our internal flight. This is the last day, sadly leaving. We're all packed in like sardines with the other school, to be honest, we don't really like, so it's quite awkward, really. So I think we're just waiting for our bags to be packed on and the other people to get ready, and then we're off for our internal flight. Fun, fun, fun.
I don't know why you think that you could hold me when you couldn't get by yourself. And I don't know who would ever wanna tell the scene of someone's dream. Baby, it's fine. You said that we should just be friends while I came up with that line. And I'm sure that it's for the best. If you ever change your mind, don't hold your breath. Look, you may not believe that, baby, I'm really when you said goodbye.
Okay, so we're now in the Antananarivo. Antananarivo airport. It's a lot harder to pronounce than it sounds, to be honest.
Tana.
People also call it, but that's minimal effort. Our flight's been delayed by like 15 minutes, which doesn't really seem to be a useful amount of time. Don't know what we can do in those 15 minutes. It's just a waste of time, really. We're just waiting around. We've got about an hour's wait now because we had to log in and everything. Came through to the gate side and wanted to spend, I've got 90,000 ariaria left. Thought I'd spend that. Turns out you can only use euros back here. So James and I just had a fun little exploration trip out the other side, and he's going to tell us how it went.
It was pretty fun. We pretty much just walked through the entirety of the security. We bought it all. We bought some really expensive rum, 38,000. Don't know how much that is in pounds again.
Like 10?
10. Still, that's pretty expensive for us at the moment because we bought some really cheap rum today. And then we walked straight back in again. Dan didn't even get ID'd and look at it. So, yeah, that was pretty fun.
Alright, girls, got anything to say?
No, except I'm happy now I've got Pringles.
You're happy you got Pringles? Okay, good. Good news!
Take up my time with thinking of our